The 31-31 series continues today. It's the Chicago Blackhawks, mm-hmm. Mike. And last year, 76 points. Last in the Central Division, they missed the playoffs by 19 points. A team that won the Stanley Cup three times from 2010 to 2015 missed the playoffs by 19 points, 18-18-5 at home. And you were just saying before we started this, you look at their lineup now and it doesn't look as intimidating as it used to, obviously.
No, not at all. I mean, I think because they had so much success and because of how much they had to pay the players that were responsible for that success, they had to get rid of so much of their depth. And so, yeah, the high-end guys, the names that you remember, the Seabrooks, the Keiths, the Taves, the Canes, they're all still there. But the supporting cast is different. Younger, they're newer, more unknowns. It's just a different kind of feel about this team. Now, they may feel the same inside because they still have some of those core pieces there. But from the outside looking in, it doesn't look like the kind of team that would compete for a cup.
And one of the biggest question in the offseason is on their goaltender, Corey Crawford. I mean, he missed the last 47 games last season with an upper body injury. He spoke at the Blackhawks convention at the end of July, and he said he's not 100% yet. He hopes to be by training camp, but he's not there yet. That's alarming. What do you take away from that? Do you think this season hinges on Corey Crawford's health?
Absolutely. Yeah. More than any other player. Taves, bounce, and none of it matters if Corey Crawford can't be healthy. And I think that's concerning. You know, even if he's able to become healthy to start camp, the fact that, you know, 7-8 months later, you know, he's still not quite right physically. I mean, I think first you start thinking about it as just him as a person. Forget the hockey player. Yeah, you want him to be healthy, to feel good, to live his life as he wants to. And then you turn to the hockey, the demands of being a high elite level goaltender like he is. If he's not right, they're in trouble because he covers up for a lot of mistakes. Yeah. I think no longer will he be underrated because he's such an important player. Yeah. Maybe last year we saw it firsthand. If he can't go and if he can't go the whole year, then they're
in trouble.
They'll repeat of last year.
They're in trouble because you look at the backup situation right now. It's Cam Ward. It at one point it was Darling and he was very good. At one point it was Ranta and he was good in that spot too. And now it's Cam Ward, a veteran guy, comes from Carolina where they've had goaltending. We've touched on this when we did the Carolina one. Mm-hmm. Goaltending issues. If Cam Ward has to start your season and Cam Ward has to be your number one goaltender, to me, and no offense to Cam Ward at this stage of his career, you're behind.
Yeah, he's not an average starter in the NHL. No. He's a below, whether 20 to 30, and if you're going to rank the goaltenders in the NHL, and he would be that. Hasn't always been. He's had a great career. You know, he's not at that point right now in it. And so that would be trouble. I mean, I'm sure Chicago is very closely monitoring Corey Crawford's health and really just crossing their fingers that he's ready to go.
The other one to look at is Jonathan Taves. He had 52 points last season, 20 goals, 32 assists.
Yeah.
Can Jonathan Taves get back to being the legit star we expect Jonathan Taves to be? And further to that, can he bring Brandon Saad along with him?
So it depends on what you think makes him a legit star.
Mm-hmm.
If it was getting 80 points,
no,
was he ever really
not,
that guy?
That's not it. That's
right?
not it.
Was it being the best player on a really good team? Well, some of the function of his star power was the fact that he led this team so much success in the playoffs. If the team's not good enough to get there, does that mean he's no longer as good of a player? Or is that because the situation's changed and he can't be considered this great leader? He'll do better next year. I believe he'll get more than 20 goals. I believe he'll get more than 52 points. I don't think he'll get 70.
No.
And I think that will be the challenge. And I don't know if he has that kind of offensive game to drag Saad
with
him.
That's the question. Can he make Saad a better player?
No, they got to work together and make each other better. Yeah. I don't think Saad's going to get drawn up the way Patrick Kane can draw guys into.
Sure.
DeBrincat could become a really good goal scorer playing with Patrick Kane. I don't think Taves has that. I don't know if he ever really had that kind of offensive dynamic game. He's still an excellent, excellent player. But both him and Saad together, not because they play with Taves, but because they're probably going to play together, have to do so much better than last year to even think about getting back in the race in the Central.
We might not expect 80 points out of Jonathan Taves, but you've got to expect more than 52, and you've got to expect Brandon Saad to be an offensive contributor.
Absolutely. Saad was very disappointing, especially the way he started last year. He's scoring lights out the first couple weeks. But, I mean, I think for Taves, if he gets in the 60s and the points, that's what you're expecting out of him at this point.
You're right. Probably tougher to drag Saad, and he's not that type of player. But now we look at it. Okay, so Crawford's health, Taves, Saad. We touched on a lot of that. You get the lineup. Is this a playoff team?
No.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I mean, you know what? They credit to Chicago is that they pushed their drop-off farther down the road than I anticipated. Yes. For a couple years prior, I'm like, they're going to be a bubble team this year, and they weren't. They won the Western Conference regular season a couple years ago. But I think, you know, they went over the cliff last year. Yeah. They'll be better than last year. I don't think they'll, if they get the goaltending. But just, they're introducing a lot of young players into their forward group, mm-hmm. and they don't have the kind of depth on defense. Keith will be better again. Seabrook is getting older now. You know, Brandon Manning, Connor Murphy, complimentary guys, but I don't know if they're reliable top four on an elite level team. Yeah. They're NHL players.
Yes.
So that's you know, given the standard we're used to holding Chicago to, individually, with their roster, with their success, this doesn't look like it's quite up to that.
I don't think they're a playoff team. I'm worried about Crawford. I'm worried about a little bit of their offense and their D. I think they're missing an element or two, mm-hmm. especially in their top four. Somebody to play with Duncan Keith. I think that's missing as well. I think there's holes in this roster that make it hard for me right now, and you as well, to pick the Blackhawks to be a playoff team.